The very first step in networking is going to be cold emailing. It's canvassing different firms, it's reaching out to people across the industry so you can generate new contacts. But the purpose of a cold email is really just to bring you to an informational interview or a coffee chat. The coffee chat is the opportunity for you to impress someone and learn more about a new firm. But having been on both sides of the conversation, I can tell when there's a good, productive coffee chat, as well as a bad one where a bad impression is made. It's really not just about having any conversation. You want to use it as an opportunity to appear thoughtful, engaged, and like a good potential employee. So I think more so in finance than in a bunch of other industries, the coffee chat is really powerful. And that's because there's so much attrition in finance. Even at the top investment banking jobs in New York or San Francisco, or the top private equity or hedge fund jobs, there is a lot of attrition. A lot of people won't even finish their first 1 or 2 years in banking because they're always looking on to the next thing. So in this kind of environment, a lot of the hiring is done haphazardly. They're really just looking for any kind of qualified or motivated people at the last second. So if you constantly have your ear to the ground, if you're speaking with a bunch of different people at all times, you're going to know when these opportunities come up. Relatedly, the HR function at a lot of these firms is not always going to be super powerful, and sometimes it's even possible to bypass headhunters. The smaller a firm is, the more likely networking and these informational interviews are going to have an impact. In some other industries, networking is not super valuable, but I'm telling you in finance that it really is. And thirdly, I think these informational chats are extremely important in finance because information is scarcely available online. It's hard to get an accurate picture of what a firm is really like to work at unless you speak with someone there. The culture in finance sometimes skews a little bit towards anonymity and secrecy, so having these coffee chats is the best way to break through that. Now, there are 3 goals in a coffee chat, the first of which is to impress the other person. You want to take this pretty seriously. You want to appear as a candidate that they would actually try to hire, someone that comes with thoughtful questions. And we'll explain how to differentiate yourself with thoughtful questions in a moment. The second goal is to learn more about that firm. Specifically, you want to learn about any potential opportunities, whether they're short term or potentially medium term, or maybe get even specific recruiting advice about what their process is like. And what I mean by this is maybe you'll learn that they're going to hire a new partner in the next 6 months, or they're going to focus on a new business unit in the next year or so. Or maybe it's even just learning that one of their associates is going to be leaving relatively soon. All of these are potential opportunities that you can kind of swoop into. And the third thing, and I think you should only ask this if you feel that the conversation is going well, but you should try to be introduced to new contacts. If you are a non-target, if you are coming from a different industry, then really the only way to sort of build out your runway is to constantly be reaching out to new people. And the best way to do that is to get a warm introduction from someone. So at the end of the conversation, again, only if it's going well, you can ask them to introduce you to 1 or 2 new people. And you just keep doing that, and that's how you have an infinite pipeline of people to talk to. So now hopefully you understand the value of a coffee chat. Now we're going to talk about how to structure one. And I would say that almost all calls follow this basic format. So I would say almost all calls are conventionally understood to be 30 minutes. That's just all modern work. The standard unit of a call is 30 minutes. In the beginning of the call, the first minute, you're just going to have some playful banter. Maybe you'll talk about things you have in common. And then you want to introduce yourself, just spend 15, 20 seconds talking about your school and what you're trying to get out of the call. And I would say the purpose generally is going to be learning about that firm, learning more about that person's career. Now, the majority of the call is going to be you functioning like a journalist. You're going to ask them detailed questions that gives them the opportunity to elaborate. So I would say you should have 10 to 15 questions prepared, each one taking about 1 to 2 minutes of their time. At the 20-minute time, you should check in with them, just make sure that they're okay for time. I would say it's generally a good indication if they're willing to run over that 30-minute time slot that the conversation is going well. Now, if you feel the conversation is going well, at the end of sort of the conversation, when you can feel it winding down, you want to make your ask. And what the ask is kind of depends on where you are in the recruiting process. But I would say generally the ask is going to be have them refer you to one of their friends that you can kind of speak to, or actually just get put straight into the recruiting process. Ask about any opportunities that might be available at their firm. And it can feel a little sleazy doing this, but trust me, they'll understand that it's a relatively transactional process. Again, I think you should only ask this if you feel the conversation is going really well and you feel that that person is going to be helpful. Just like how a cold email, the main goal is to get to a conversation, the purpose of a conversation is really just to improve your chances for the candidacy at their firm. But before you can even think of making that ask, you gotta hit them with a bunch of thoughtful questions. And this is what we mean by thoughtful. A yes or no question is not thoughtful. You wanna give them something that they can really elaborate on and have good detail packed into their answer. You wanna ask about things that you can't easily Google. So don't ask about who the founder of the firm was, or what the revenue was, or how to build a DCF. These are things that are very easily found online. Relatedly, you wanna ask things that are very specific to that person. So if they had an interesting career switch, if they moved from maybe the West Coast office to the East Coast, you can ask about why they made that switch, how they've liked working with different industries, is the culture different between these offices? Things that really flesh out their own career decisions. And also importantly, I wouldn't ask anything that can even kind of be perceived as somewhat antagonistic. For example, if they made a career move to a smaller firm, I would be careful in how you ask why they made that move. Don't ask, why are you focusing on smaller deals? Maybe to say, it looks like you're moving to a firm that has tons of growth opportunities, that's focusing on really interesting businesses. Can you tell me about that? I think people in finance and just most hardworking people in general have a little bit of an ego, and you shouldn't try to threaten that in any sense, I would say, in your first interaction. More specifically, when I think about the actual questions to ask them, I'll start with the career as well as their perspective. What are the job responsibilities that they have? What are important career decisions that they made, and how would they reflect upon them? What are the favorite parts they like about working at that firm? It's also good to talk about the firm and business model. How do they differentiate themselves from their competitors? What's important to the business's success in the future? How is the organization structured, as well as deal teams and the day-to-day operations? And I think thirdly, only if things are going well, you kind of unlock the conversation and you can ask about maybe the hours or the culture and the lifestyle at that firm. It can be kind of uncomfortable to ask specifically about hours. So what I like to do is either ask, what does a typical week look like for you? Or does your business have some seasonality and how does it impact your day-to-day? Things that are a little bit more gentle. And again, if things are going well, you can ask about introductions, ask about things that directly impact your career. So when the call is winding down or reaching a natural endpoint, or maybe getting close to that 30-minute mark, I'll almost always say the following three things. I'll start by just giving an open general question in case I didn't ask something that they want to talk about. Knowing what you know about me and my situation, is there anything by way of general recruiting advice that you can give to me? Next, I'll try to regurgitate one or two things that they said that I thought were particularly interesting or noteworthy. Maybe it's a funny anecdote that they mentioned, or something about a project that they're working on, or a deal that they're gonna announce in a few weeks that you say you'll look out for. Small details that kind of just make it a little bit more personal. And lastly, I'll just try to leave the door open to future interactions. I'll say, thank you so much for taking some time to speak to me today. I've been really looking forward to this conversation. I was just wondering if it's okay if I can send you any follow-ups. And almost everyone is going to say yes to that, and that's really how you keep the relationship going. If you see anything in the news that's interesting, any articles that might be interesting to them, or things that happen in your own life, then just send them a quick email as an update. So I do hope that this was helpful for you. If you'd like to learn more about private equity recruiting or check out our other career resources, you can do so by going to peakframeworks.com. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.